Okay, so today what we're actually going to talk about is building up an audience and how to kind of view it just like you would a professional sports arena. Hey there, my name is Chris Hughes, and in this video, what I want to do is actually share with you the concept, the way that I build up audiences, and kind of let you in on the thought process behind it so that you can start to understand this for yourself and implement it for your business. So to start off with, what I want you to think about is a huge arena. And the reason to picture an arena is because this is like what Facebook is. So we'll say this is, you know, like a basketball court. And I like basketball, so it's very easy for me to imagine this. But what we're doing is we're picturing this is the group of people. So imagine that there were, you know, 100,000 people in the stands here. 100,000 people in the stands. How crazy is that? Can you imagine putting your business in front of 100,000 people? Well, it's actually a lot easier than you might imagine. And I'm going to show you why that is the case in this video. So think about this. Picture what your business would look like, you know, a year from now if you were able to get in front of 100,000 people who are interested in your stuff. So right off the bat, you might have some resistance, and that's understandable because you may have never gotten in front of 100,000 people before. So the thing that I personally look at, like the way that I view this, I'm using basketball in the example, but if you're a musician, this works just as good. If you're a business owner, this works just as good. If you're anyone who's building up a brand, this is the 50,000 foot view or whatever you want to consider it. So what I want you to think about is this 100,000 people, the ones who might be interested in your stuff. Think about that for just a second. Like, take the time right now to stop and actually think about who that dream person is. You might have heard it as the dream 100, the people who are, you know, the most perfect for your business. So think about them. And on Facebook, we have the opportunity to, you know, type in interests and get in front of that 100,000 people. So what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna show you the strategy I use, and you can start doing it yourself starting today. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna create some videos. So this is like me right now, I'm creating a video. This is step one of the process. This is the first thing that it begins with, is this little video. So there's me, and what I'm doing is I'm teaching something. I'm educating my target market, the 100,000 people who might be interested in this. And right off the bat, guess what's gonna happen? People aren't gonna care. Let's say that, you know, 80% of these people don't care, which is pretty normal because attention spans are really low, especially now it's like 7 seconds or something. So let's say 80% of those people don't care. So now you're down to 20,000 people. The good news is if you can get 20,000 people to watch your first video, if you can get 20,000 people to watch and consume and learn and kind of like you, what happens is on Facebook, you can use what's known as custom audiences. You can pick, like, if someone watched 50% of your video, if someone watched 75% of your video, if someone watched 95% of your video. If you were doing like a 10 minute video and someone watched 75% of that, that's 7 minutes. Like, that's a long time for someone to be engaged with your content, right? What you're actually doing here is you're building up custom audiences based on what people have done based on the data that you're given. So right off the bat, I bumped it down, 80% didn't watch it. And we're gonna say that, you know, we'll do 50% watched, let's say 10 seconds. So 10,000 people watched 10 seconds, and then like 2,000 people watched, let's do like 5 minutes. Which is awesome. If you can get 2,000 people who are watching and consuming your content for 5 minutes, that right there is a very targeted lead for you. So what do you do with this? How do you actually implement this in your business? Why should you care? Why should you pay any attention? Great questions. But the reason for this is if you have people out of this 100,000 that you started off with your first ad, you put it out to the 100,000 people and you're letting people review your content, most people drop off. There's certain people that will stay and consume the content. So if this is making sense, like, say this is making sense down below in the comments. But what you do is you take the people who watched a large percentage of your content, and what do? Well, you put, you know, another ad in front of them. So this is gonna be an ad that targets the 2,000 people. Okay, so if you're looking at this from any type of data standpoint, if you get someone watching a video for 5 minutes, they like you. So if you're still watching, what's cool is that you're probably learning something. You're probably getting some value out of this. It might be helping you in some way or another. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to set up a retargeting ad, something that's gonna kind of put another relevant offer in front of you. And I'm working on, I just bought the domain name ibuildaudiences.com, so I'm gonna put up a free class there that'll kind of explain this in more detail so that way it's easy to understand. But what's gonna happen is the people who watched a lot of the content, I'm going to only target those people with the ad that provides like the call to action to get people to the next step. And you can apply this with anything. Like if you're a musician and you have a music video that's 5 minutes long, if you can get someone to watch 3 minutes or 4 minutes of that music video, so you're gonna be able to turn these people into fans. And what happens with the fans? Well, in the instance with musicians, they're gonna be the ones to buy tickets to your shows. They're gonna be the ones to buy your music on iTunes and Spotify and all the other, like Google Music, whatever the other networks are for music distribution. Same is true with authors. If you can get someone to consume a piece of content that's, you know, based around the concepts that you cover in your book, guess what? If you put the book in front of them, there's a good chance that they're gonna become customers from you. The audiences that we have here, they're not wasted. The good news is, if you've got someone who watched 10 seconds of a video, you can still retarget them with another piece of content. So this would be like the hyper-targeted people, and then there's the people who watched 10 seconds. So for the 10-second viewers, what you wanna do is you wanna kind of, you know, pull them along. Maybe it just wasn't the right time for them to consume the content. You know, they might have been out, they might not have been on their computer, they might not have been ready at home on Wi-Fi, so they're wasting data. So what you can do is the people who did watch 10 seconds, you can put another, like relatively short, like a 3-minute video in front of this audience to kind of, you know, pick and choose from the people who are consuming a large percentage of it. So like I mentioned at the beginning, we were using a 10-minute video for this. With a 10-minute video, that's a long time for someone to watch. That's a long time for someone to consume, unless they're getting entertained or they're getting value or they're, you know, getting something to put more money in their pockets. And that's my goal with this, is to help you learn something that you can apply that will help grow your business. So with this, the 10-second viewers, what do? Well, you put another ad in front of them that's relevant to that. Something that's kinda, you know, like I mentioned, pull them along the line, pull them along like the buying cycle, the process, like give them more value, give them something that will help them solve their problem, or like a cheat sheet or something that makes logical sense in the relationship, because they're still kind of a cold audience. So these, the people who watched for the full 5 minutes, it's a pretty warm prospect. The people who watched 10 seconds, it's still kinda cold. It's like seeing a billboard driving down the highway. Like, you see it, you'll register it, but you might not understand what it is or what problem it actually solves. The cool thing about that is with billboards, like if you have like 5 in a row, you're gonna see, oh, like that was, what was that? And then the next time you see it, it'll kind of make a little more sense. It'll kind of move along in the progression. And I don't see that often. Like, there's not many companies who do that. Like, oh, you missed our billboard, like, follow up. But that's besides the point. So with this concept, the idea is always to start with the ideal audience, create a piece of content for them, let the ideal people find it. And this is gonna cost money. It's not gonna be free. Like, you can spend $5 or $10 a day on this just to put it out there and then find those warm people, find the people who are, you know, super interested in the thing, and then follow up with them. What happens is it's usually cheaper to retarget the people who consumed a lot of content because there's less competition for them. Because you've already built up like the, I think it's believed, like the pixeled audience. So I just wanted to share this idea, this concept, and give you some action steps, things that you can take today and implement them in your business. So that way you can, you know, benefit from this, so that I'm giving you something of value in exchange for your time, just as a hopefully this helps develop the relationship long-term for us, and, you know, good things happen out of that. So there's gonna be a free class on ibuildaudiences.com. Go there at the end of this video and you'll be able to see the class, consume it. It's gonna be free content. It's gonna be things you can take and apply immediately to grow your business. So thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. Be sure to leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and thanks for your time. We'll see you in the next video.